National Indoor Arena in Birmingham. And, well, we've scoured the breadth and the length of this country to find the very best contenders to take on the ultimate challenge of our gladiators.
Yes, and four of those contenders will be trying to pit their skills against the gladiators and try and win their way through the quarterfinals and maybe even the grand finals and all the prizes that go with it.
Our female contenders tonight. They are Sophie Cheston
and Helen Williams.
Now, Sophie, I know for a fact you're from around my way, aren't you?
Yeah, we went to middle school together.
Yes.
It was a pleasure.
So tell me, what did you go on to do after that then?
I'm now a teacher, physical education at the Chalfonts Community College.
I bet you're popular tonight. So tell me, what sort of sports and what sort of things do you enjoy doing?
I row, I mountain bike, I windsurf, I climb mountains, I push cars, anything really.
I think that says it all. I think our gladiators have really got their work cut out.
Yeah, they have.
They have. Well, we'll see you a little bit later on. Sophie Cheston! Off we go.
So, Helen, how do you feel? You feel nervous?
Very nervous, John, yes.
OK, Helen. So what do you do for a living?
I'm a medical representative.
And what hobbies you got?
I do powerlifting and I ride my motorbike.
Powerlifting? Ooh, that's heavy stuff. Won any major prizes?
Yep, I've won 10 British and European titles.
Come on! That's some heavy going. So, do you think that's going to help you tonight?
These girls think they've seen strength, but they have not seen anything till they meet a powerlifter.
OK, Helen, we'll leave it at that. Off you go. Thanks very much. Helen Williams!
Let's meet the guys. Alan Bates.
And Brian Ward. Great entrance.
Tell us a little bit about yourselves, what you do and where you're from.
Well, I'm from Enniskill in County Fermanagh, Northern Ireland, and I'm living and working in Belfast at present as a sports coach.
Now, I know you had a major setback when you were quite young. What was that?
Initially, when I started training, I was diagnosed a diabetic, so it took me a little while to control things, but now it's just a small inconvenience as far as I'm concerned.
That is absolutely terrific, and in fact, I know as well that you went on to pick up one or two medals.
Well, I was very lucky. I got a silver medal in the Commonwealth Championships in canoeing, and I came second in the World Superstars as well, so
lucky enough. So really, we're dealing with a very, very experienced man.
Used to. That was 4 or 5 years ago. Now I'm enjoying life a little bit more, golfing and mountain biking.
Well, listen, I know you're very fit, so you're going to give them... You're going to give them hell.
100%.
All right then, Alan. We'll see you later. Alan Bates.
Brian, now you're in the RAF. How long have you been in the RAF?
14 years now, John.
And what do you do? What else do you do? Any hobbies, anything else?
I'm just sport mad. Sport Billy's my nickname. That's me.
What sort of sports you do? Tell us.
Everything I can get hold of. Triathlon, boxing, running, cycling, swimming, anything. Just love sport.
You do all of those?
Everything.
Tell us about your supporters you've got in the audience. They're very vocal.
I got loads and loads of good guys out there from everywhere.
You certainly have. OK, Brian, thanks very much.
Yes, John.
Thanks,
Brian.
Should be ready for their first event by now, so here's John Sachs to tell us about it.
Thanks, Ulrika. Powerball kicks us off this evening. Our gladiator's job is to block contenders out of the points. Sophie will be using the red balls, and our powerlifter Helen will be getting to grips with the blue. Back to the Powerball pitch and Fash.
So Helen and Sophie are ready, and they're going to be facing three of our gladiators: Nightshade, Falcon, and Panther. John Anderson.
Contenders, ready! Gladiators, ready! Three, two, one.
Let's play
played ball. The power lifter powers through. Helen straight off the mark with two. Great take down there. Don't forget two for an out of basket, three for the centre. And this is real physical stuff. Good takedown. That ball redundant now. Oh, kept out by Nightshade. And look at Falcon. Really the master of this game. Oh, insist that one goes in. Sophie popped in for two. And another two for Helen. They split legs. Oh, Nightshade not getting that one out of the way. But look at Falcon. Superb at that tackle. Look at that. That is typical Panther. She keeps trying to push those contenders down. She should take a leaf out of Falcon's book and commit to the tackle. Better by Nightshade there. In the replay, we can see the contenders really earn their points in Powerball. Sophie scores but pays the price.
Well done, Sophie. Welcome to the Gladiators. How was that first event?
That was like Bray duty on a Friday morning.
That tough?
That was hard. They are very, very physical.
Well, you got 4 points.
Thank you. Well done,
Sophie.
Thank you.
Well, Helen, our power lifter, you ploughed through them, didn't you?
Well, I certainly tried to. The rather large one was stopping a few times, though.
Well, you'll be pleased to know, Helen, you got 8 points! Woo! Woo! Well done. Get yourselves ready for the next event.
And brother Richard delighted for Helen. She goes straight into the lead. After the first event, Sophie's on 4, Helen's on 8. As we move on to the men's event.
Brian and Alan are going to be facing Shadow Warrior and Wolfman.
Should be the dream team, the speed and tackling agility of Warrior, the single-minded, unmitigated power of Shadow, and the pure, horrible meanness of Wolf.
Contenders, ready! Gladiators, ready! Three, two, one!
Let's play ball. If you had any doubts about these man mountains moving, look at Warrior like Quicksilver there. Oh, me and my Shadow, what a great takedown on Alan. And look at that shirt, what's left of it. Brian having to work hard. And Shadow not even letting him out of the box. Oh, Wolfie. Shadow. A clean sheet for the Gladiators. Tackle by Warrior and Shadow. That must have felt like the house coming down. Look at that! What a rugby tackle from the Warrior! 21 stone moving across the floor. Time up, guys. And look at that sheer relief.
Play against us?
It's going to be hard work.
Well, Brian, done anything like this in the RAF before?
Closest thing is trying to get the comfy chair in the crew room, that's about it. Pretty hard stuff.
It certainly looked it. Alan, can we ask you, any bumps, knocks, bruises?
Like one terrible tackle at the start. It's just like a steamroller running over you.
This is not really the first event you really wanted, is it, guys? Nice little warm-up for you, though, isn't it?
Well warmed up. I hoped it would be the last one. The chances of injury, got through without an injury, so good for that.
Oh, we got a few more guys. Well done.
Nice.
Very sporting. Very sporting. Well done.
All right. Yeah.
Great stuff. Well done, guys. Well done. Let's hear it for the Gladiators. Come on.
Let's go.
A clean sheet for our Gladiators. A complete shutout. Both male contenders clock up 0 points.
It's mean, it's moody, and it's magnificent, and it stands 36 feet high. You've guessed it, it's the wall. Basically, our contenders have just 60 seconds in which to climb it. But don't forget now, after 10 seconds, they'll be hotly pursued by two of our gladiators. Helen's going to be chased by Zodiac!
There she is, British pole vault champion.
And Sophie's going to be followed by Scorpio. Yes!
And Sophie had better watch out. This is Scorpio's favourite event.
Over to John Anderson.
3, 2, 1.
And the girls are away. 60 seconds to get to the summit. But this first 10 seconds of free climb is all important. Here comes trouble. Here come the gladiators. On the right-hand side, Scorpio strikes out, but Sophie slipped her. Zodiac gets a grip, but oh, Helen pulls away and over for 10 points. And it's Scorpio on Sophie. She's got her, proving why this is Scorpio's favourite event.
Helen, 10 points, well done.
I just don't believe I got up that wall.
You were a bit worried about that, first of all, weren't you?
I tell you, with stuff like that in front of you, you don't need fibre in your diet.
Oh, well, that's one way of looking at it, I suppose. After two events, Sophie remains on 4, Helen climbs to 18. Across to the men's wall, and Alan here proving that diabetes needn't restrict your life.
I take 3 insulin shots every day, one in the morning before breakfast, one 5 o'clock before my evening meal, and then before I go to bed. Again, checking my sugar level and stuff as I go along. One of the biggest problems, actually, if I went to a competition, usually you have butterflies in your stomach and so forth. It's very, very similar to your sugar level going low. So you'd be sitting there wondering, is my sugar level low or am I nervous? So you'd take your blood sample and suddenly it would come out high and you say, oh, goodness, I'm nervous. So you have to be careful and just monitor yourself as you're going along.
And standing at the foot of the wall is Alan. He's going to be chased by the Cobra.
Alan has conquered his disability. Let's see if he can conquer the Cobra.
For Brian, he's going to be chased by the Wolfman.
Now, who let that lot in? And who let him out?
Over to John Anderson.
3, 2, 1.
And here come Brian and Alan. And, of course, 2 overhangs on the men's wall. Here comes trouble. It's Cobra and Wolf. Look at that. What an incredible distance between Wolf and Brian. A Wolfman not impressing his fan club on this occasion. He's already over for 10 points. And look at the distance between Cobra. And another 10 points. Both guys relieved to get off the mark and onto the scoreboard.
Brian made that look very easy. 10 points. Well done.
Good event for me, John. Bad one for the Wolfman.
Yes, it certainly was. Have you done it before?
Once or twice.
Yeah, I think you have. Well done, Brian. Well done. Alan! Another one. 10 points. Any plans or did you just go for it?
I had a plan worked out at the start and I got over the middle and then I heard the whistle for the 10-second start. Mine just went blank for a second. I forgot exactly which direction I wanted to go and then I just suddenly came back and I was away.
Well done, Alan. 10 points!
This is what the Wolf fans want. This is what they've come for. So all square after the second event, 10 points apiece. Moving on to event 3, and hang tough. And Sophie's first to go.
Yes, up there on the hang tough platform is Sophie. And she's going to be against Jet.
What is going on here? These Wolf fans. penalty.
Over to John Anderson.
Contender, ready! Gladiator, ready! Three, two, one!
It's swing time, and school teacher Sophie swoops out into no man's land. 50 feet between her and Jet's platform. And both girls look very comfortable up there. Oh, Sophie tries to slip past Jet. And Jet goes for the body scissors. And Sophie tries to tie her up. Jet puts the weight on her body, presses the down button, and it's final time. Oh. Now, has Jet hurt her back? No, she's fine. Good sportsmanship. But another one bites the dust. Cue those glad hands, please.
And next up is our power lifter, Helen. Over to John Anderson.
Contender, ready! Gladiator, ready! Three, two, one!
It's swing time, and this is Helen's favourite event. Well, she certainly got the upper body strength. But is it a match for the skill of Jet? Jet biding her time before she moves in. And come into my parlor, said the spider to the fly. Jet locks on with those body scissors. Helen proving her strength one-handed there. Oh, but look at Jet proving her skill by taking her down. Eat mat.
Brilliant. Helen, well done. For a split second there, I think you carried all of you and her with one arm.
I tell you, John, I think if I'd managed to keep both hands on the rings, I'd have done it. But I took a hand off, and not even I can hold my weight and Jet's weight on one hand.
Well, this event is all about upper body strength, and you've got plenty of that. But unlucky. Well done, Helen.
Thanks very much, John. Thanks, everyone.
Well, Jack, that on two hands, she could have hung tough.
Thank you.
Well done, you two. Very sporting. On to the next.
Yeah, tremendous camaraderie amongst contenders and gladiators. After three events, the scores stay the same. Sophie 4, Helen 18.
Yes, and next up is the boys' event. And up there is Alan. And he's going to be against Shadow. Take us away.
Contender, ready! Gladiator, ready! Three, two, one!
And by the way, this is Shadow's debut on Hang Tough. And even from 50 feet away, who'd want to swing into the path of that giant? Eyes. And I'm moving quickly. Oh, he's lost the ring.
Well, Alan, threw away 10 valuable points there. You were past him.
I was past him. I thought he was coming alongside there, and I was going for the red ring. Looking around, I should have concentrated on the ring. Just missed it by a fraction.
Well, it's got to be a pretty frightening sight, isn't it? Seeing Shadow flying along like that at you.
He gets bigger as he gets closer.
Okay, Alan, never mind. Thanks very much, Alan. And now we have our man from the RAF, Brian!
Come on, Brian!
Come on, Brian!
Two, one!
Helen was very good at this in practice. And immediately into the scoring zone. Oh, no, he's missed it! Shadow's got his back at him. Brian all the time checking where the Shadow is. And he's too busy concentrating on Shadow rather than going for that platform. Looks like Alan summed it up perfectly. The closer Shadow gets, the bigger he gets. Both one ringed at the moment, searching for another. And this one is going nowhere. Except down. Both contenders finding themselves intimidated out of the points. And Brian failed to pick up any points. Scores remain the same after three events. Here's Fash.
So don't go away. Join us after the break when you can see some more exciting action on the Gladiators!
Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena where we're set up for our fourth event, Swing Shot. Standing poised on their platforms are Sophie! And trying to catch them will be Nightshade and Scorpio.
The intensive training and preparation contenders have to go through can be exhausting, as Sophie found out.
Every muscle aches. Last few days has been an eye-opener, really. I've always been in a situation where I've been not the top, but felt confidence with my own ability. And you have this image of being a PE teacher, of being fit and healthy. And I've come here and I've seen 16 superb athletes in a great range of abilities. And everyone's been very impressive. Everyone's had their strengths and weaknesses. It's going to be very interesting on the day, see actually what happens.
3, 2, 1!
Swing out, sisters. 3 for red, 2 for blue, 1 for yellow ball. And both girls grab a yellow. In the basket. And a free swing there for Helen. Grabs a blue for 2. And those Gladiators just too late. Seconds behind as they peel off another point. Helen reaches up, both peeling 2 yellows. Sophie, up she goes, and Nightshade too late. She gets the yellow. Up goes Helen, and Scorpio too late. She's got a blue in her beak and in the basket. Only seconds on the clock as Sophie has one more try. There's the block. If she'd done that earlier, we may have blocked some of these points out. As we can see in the replay, Scorpio grabs Sophie's shot cord, taking the momentum out of her swing. After 4 events, Sophie's on 8. Helen bounces up to 24.
Contenders ready! Gladiators ready! 3, 2, 1!
Guys swing their thing, and traffic busy up there tonight, but that's a blue for 2 points. Brian bags that in the basket. And up they go, and in that chaos, who came away with anything? Tremendous fun, this, but remember, kids, don't try this at home with Dad's braces. Look at that! Oh! Another 2 points there, that's even the score. Alan reaches, but fumbles! Oh, and Brian pinches a point in that pile-up. And a free swing. And too late, mistiming his swing there. We're out of time. Scores after four events. Alan's on 12, Brian marginally ahead on 15. Event 5, Duel. Over to you, Fash.
Well, thanks, Sax. Well, up on her platform, getting ready to do battle, is Sophie! And she's going to be battling against Lightning! Over to John Anderson.
On guard. 3, 2, 1.
Well, Sophie is stone heavier than Lightning and straight down to business. Lightning taking some stick. And what a strike rate. Oh, Lightning earthed. Well, a relentless pounding there from Sophie. And don't her school children love it?
Sophie, well done.
I needed that, boy. I needed that. She's,
Oh, plenty of support you've got.
Yeah, a few of my mates over there came to say hello. That was fun. That was incredible.
Well done. You deserved it. Well done, Sophie.
Thank you.
Great performance from our school teacher, but if she obliterated Lightning that easily, what's an 11-stone powerlifter going to do?
3, 2, 1.
Lightning gets to work, and so does Helen. And notice the difference in the grips there. Lightning with the shorter grip. Oh, she nearly got over them! And Helen using a longer swing. So if that makes contact, you'll feel it. Lightning all over the place. If she steps across, it's all over. Good duck there from Helen. Reckless stuff there from Lightning. Nearly loses her stick. Oh, and an extra stick there from Helen. Well, I think we'll make up though, and that's it. We're all friends here on this show.
She's still there.
Well, Helen, that looked a tough one. Looked real.
It was real, all right. I think that Sophie had got her back up just to touch that.
Lightning, does she hit hard?
She certainly does. That was a tough competition. The first one started up even more. Yeah. So I found it quite tough, but I was very determined. I'm surprised I didn't knock her off.
Well, you two looked like you didn't want to give up. Yeah. John Anderson blew the referee the whistle, and you still wanted to continue.
I would admit that was my fault. That was bad sportsmanship, very naughty. I apologise.
You did apologise at the time, though.
Good contest, you two. Well done.
Lightning took some heavy blows there, but did well to hold Helen to 5 points. So after five events, Sophie's on 18, Helen 29.
Oh, kicking us off on the men's event. Up there on the platform is Alan. And he's going to be facing Trojan.
On guard. 3, 2, 1.
Straight to work. Straight across and straight down. Good night, Vienna. And that's where he went wrong. Alan steps across, instant disqualification, or as we say in the business, instant DQ. Let's find out a bit more about a day in the life of our RAF engineer.
Well, I start work about 8 o'clock in the morning. Get in, have to get all my denims on, get barrier cream and stuff like that, because I work with a lot of oils and stuff, and you can get dermatitis, all kinds of stuff off it. And then into the hangar, find out what's wrong with the aircraft, what's happened from the night before, what snags they've got, pick it all up, go out and just mend it, fix it all. You have to work to a tight schedule. Everything's got to be logged, everything you do, you sign for. If you've got people's lives, anything I do wrong, I don't do anything wrong, but if something went wrong, somebody's life's on the line. You know? Pilot goes for something and it's not there. If you've left a pin in or a nut and bolt's not in, he's dead, you know. So it's not a job that's taken lightly. Everything's serious. You're right in there. You've got a job to do and you do it.
And he's got a job to do right now.
3, 2, 1.
good work rate from Brian. And Trojan's got a fight on his hands this time. Oh, look at those lovely jabs from Brian. What's Trojan going to do to answer back to that? Oh, and that! Oh, Trojan through the defence with a hook to have a blow, and who put the lights out? Oh, Michelle felt that. Neither of the guys adding to their scores there. After five events, Alan still on 12, Brian 15. Tilt is event 6.
Contender, ready? Gladiator, ready!
Panther, the first to get to grips with this event.
Hit the stream.
First pull.
3, 2, 1.
The advantage with the lower table. Panther's got to get her tilt table back. No chance. The crowd love it. Sophie's stats, same weight and height as Panther, but has the advantage of the lower tilt table. Second pull.
3, 2, 1.
And this time, Panther's getting the table back. That's what it's all about, and it looks like this one could go all the way. Neither one giving an inch. Determination of those girls. And there's the whistle. Sophie picking up 5 points from the first pull, 2 points for the draw, 7 in all. And soaking up the acclaim.
And next up for her tug of war is Helen. She's going to be facing Falcon.
Take the string.
First pull.
3, 2, 1.
And our Powerball princess has drawn the short straw. And it's all over. If we look at Helen's stats, we can see that Falcon is giving away half a stone, plus, of course, the disadvantage of being on that higher tilt table. Second pull.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, Falcon manages somehow to get her tilt table back. But not for long. Falcon plucked from her nest, unable to cope with the strength of Helen. Richard and Mum celebrate there. Scores after 6 events. Sophie's on 25, Helen on 39. Let's join Uli for the men's event.
And first up is Alan, and he's facing Hunter. Over to John Anderson.
Take the strain.
First pull.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, Alan looked a little previous there, but the referee seems to have let it go. Oh, and Hunter's let it go. And looking at Alan's stats, he's given away 6 stone, 5 inches, and 17 years.
Take the screen.
Alan old enough to be his father, Hunter only 19.
3, 2, 1.
And this time gets the table back. And listen to that aggression. Oh, he reels him in. And he's run out of rope.
Last person you want to speak to after that?
I had a good momentum going on the first one. The second one got a little jerk and just knocked me off balance. And once he got me off balance, it's very difficult to get your weight back again. He kept pulling the whole time. I thought I would have got the second one. Very disappointed, but
well, 5 points.
My best.
5 points are yours anyway. Okay, well done, Alan.
Well done indeed for getting 5 points out of Hunter. And his family, they're discussing what went wrong.
Next up is Brian, who faces the one and only Saracen. Over to John Anderson.
Take the strain.
First pull.
3, 2, 1.
Saracen's got it back now. Oh, my goodness, what happened there? And Brian's mum doesn't know what happened either.
The result of the first pool, a win to the contender, 5 points.
And Saracen not happy with that. Well, let's see the replay. And if you ask me, too close to call. The buck stops with the referee. Second pull.
One.
Oh, Saracen slips, but he's got it back. Must get to his feet or he'll be disqualified. But he's up and he's fired up for this second pull. Oh, and he's yanked him up with ease. Well, look at that. Saracen not best pleased. He won't be buying that referee a beer tonight. So after six events, Alan's on 17, Brian just ahead on 20.
We're going to take a short break now, because after six events, we're going to await the nail-biting eliminator. So join us here on Gladiators! Welcome back to the National Indoor Arena. Well, now that we've successfully eliminated our gladiators, it's time for our contenders to try to eliminate each other. But before they do so, here's John Sachs with news of last week's competition.
Thank you, Ulrika, and congratulations to our winner who successfully guessed that this pretty young thing grew up to be lightning. And now for gladiator fans who want to know more about her, let's hear from the lady herself.
I was born in Burntwood, which is where I live at the moment with my parents and my sister. Lived there all my life. Never moved out of Burntwood. My sister started gymnastics at an early age. By the time I was six, I decided I wanted to follow her footsteps. I trained in the British Squad at the age of 12. I used to train at Lillishaw, which was like a pit, a dome. Trained there with top British coaches about 4 or 5 times a week, actually. And on a Sunday, sometimes we trained for 8 hours a day. It was very intense training. But that's all I ever did when I was young. I went to school. Bit of a rebel at school, actually. And then went training, and that was it. I gave up at the age of 15 actually. The reason was because all my friends at school used to say, oh, come out, you know, we're going to this disco, it's really good, you'll like it. And for a long time, I kept refusing. I was saying, no, I have to go training. And they knew that I had to go training anyway at gymnastics. And the one night, I thought, well, OK, just to shut them up, I'll go, find out what it's like, see how it goes. And I really enjoyed myself when I got back. And then after that, I found out I was trying to skive more nights off training to go out to discos, and I started meeting boys. And that was it, really. I found out I enjoyed myself more out of gymnastics than what I did while I was training. But that is one thing that I do regret out of life. I should never give up.
Contenders can't give up now as we move on to the eliminator. Sophie's had great support all evening, and she's going to need it now because she's trailing by 14 points, which gives Helen a 7-second head start.
Well, Sophie, here we are, the end of all the events. Now, earlier you said that the Eliminator was your favourite event. Do you still feel the same way?
Always, always save the best to the last. That's my motto.
How do you think you're going to do?
I'm going to kill her.
Whoa, that's strong words. So you've been saving a little bit, have you?
I've saved everything, John.
Well, we'll see. Thanks very much. OK, Helen. Now, do you think that your powerlifting is going to help you on any of these?
Yeah, the powerlifting is going to help on anything that involves the upper body, which is a fair amount of this course.
So you fancy your chances?
Well, I've just got to go and do what I'm going to go and do, my best.
Great stuff. Well, either way, see you on the other side. All the best, both of you.
Helen, you will go on my first whistle. Sophie, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
So, Helen has 7 seconds to make the most of this head start with the high and low hurdles. That rope really does take it out of you on the upper body. So does this fella, the overhead ladder. Plenty of support from brother Richard there. Across the rolling beam and onto the grueling cargo net. Sophie still struggling there on the overhead. Don't forget, if she drops, it's 10 seconds penalty time. She sure is keeping it going, and here comes Sophie, the joiner. And Helen making hard work of this cargo net. Down that 90-foot zip line for a splashdown. Sophie supporters willing her to the top. Meanwhile, it's the balance beam, and has she saved enough for this travelator? Deep breath. Sophie right behind her. And she's pumping it all the way to the top. Oh, yes, grabs the rope. A little wiggle, cheeky thing. To the top, grab the rope, great contender, sideways through.
Helen, congratulations. How do you feel?
I'm absolutely exhausted.
Well, was it worth it?
It was worth it, John. It was brilliant. My mum's here. I thank her for her support.
Well, well done, Helen. Congratulations! Another winner on the Gladiators!
Sophie, there's the support you've had all throughout this evening's performance.
I just want to say, everyone, I love every single kid out there. I may not meet out on Tuesday morning, but I love every single kid. And they're noisy, aren't they?
They're noisy, but they've supported you throughout this. You've shown tremendous confidence, in fact. And we're very sorry to lose you.
I'll be back.
Well done, Sophie.
Thank you.
There's Helen to greet you. And at the end of that nail biter, it's straight over to the men's competition, and here's John Sachs to fill us in on all the information.
Uli, Brian leads Alan by 3 points, giving him a 1.5 second head start. Brian's wife Michelle's been his biggest supporter all evening. Let's find out how they met.
I met my wife at school. She sent me a Valentine's card when we was about 15. It was given to me by another girl called Susan Crump. She's famous now. And I threatened her. I said, right, who gave you this card? I want to know now. And she said, I can't tell you, I can't tell you. I said, I want to know who gave you this card or I'm going to kill you. She says, it was Michelle Clough. So I asked her out and we went out for a day and she didn't like me. And then she wouldn't stop following me about after that. So I thought, well, okay, I'll try again. So we went out again, that was it. We've been gone ever since I was 16. So I'm 30 now, so 14 years we've been together. It's great, it's still fresh.
And the great news is Michelle's expecting a baby pretty soon.
Brian, you will go on my first whistle. Alan, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
The whistles are together, and so are Brian and Alan. Now, the rope can make a difference. But it hasn't. It's neck and neck. The guys, of course, on the hand bikes. Easy, Michelle. So Brian across the rolling beams and onto the cargo. And he's very fast up that cargo net. Alan's joining him. And he made short work of that. Foot down the zip line. Shaky on that balance beam. Has he saved enough for the travelator? As Alan does a tumble. And he's doing it. He's pumping it. He's made it. Grabs the rope and Geronimo into the quarter final. And Michelle. shall celebrate. Settle down, we shall. We don't want two celebrations in one night. Up the travelator in one, grabs the rope, and what a tremendous contender he has been.
Brian, well done. Congratulations. Another winner.
Thanks, John. It's great. Really, really hard work. Dried you out that.
Well, Brian, that was a tough one. Just look on the cargo net where you thought you just got away from him then.
Yeah, yeah. Cargo net's my favourite bit. Most of the lads don't like that, but I love it. I really enjoy going up there.
Well, you certainly showed it. Well done, Brian.
Cheers, John. Thank you.
Well done, Brian.
What can I say? That's it.
I started catching in the early stages and I thought it was going to be a very close race, but I just lost it a little bit on the net. I was looking at my hands too much, not my feet. But it was a good race. Brian's a very good competitor. With some very, very difficult events earlier on. And anybody who thinks it's easy should come along and try it. It's very, very hard work. I thought I was fit before I came here. It's hard work.
Thank you very much, Alan.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Alan said it all. This competition really is the ultimate challenge.
Yes, next week we'll be back again. Four more contenders, and you can see them face the ultimate challenge of the Gladiators.
It was the staple of weekend telly. This is the quiz game of childhood dreams. You can never, ever beat a bit of bully. Bullseye is coming up next on Challenge.
Let the game begin, time to come along. You can take control and feel the draw. Throw it down to the front of the Eliminator. Let's go, we're breaking it down with the Gladiators. Cause you may see a dark town block out the lunch.
Do not attempt to recreate any of the events you have seen on Gladiators. Both contenders and gladiators have been trained for this competition, and safety equipment is mandatory. The Gladiators.